Radhe Radhe everyone. Today we are going to practice Rup Dhyan meditation about loving remembrance of Sri Radha Krishna. My humble pranams to my Gurudev's divine lotus feet for giving this world the precious treasure of Rup Dhyan practice to get rid of all the material afflictions and to keep the mind calm, peaceful. How exercises keeps our body fit like that for the mind as well. We have exercise. What is that? To think, to meditate, to visualize upon the saintly people, God and Guru will help us to get rid of all the pains, fear, anxiety, anger, greed, negative thoughts, to get rid of our mind. If we really want to practice properly, you all can join us. If you are really interested, please email at gloriesofshriradhakrishna@gmail.com. Now let's focus on loving remembrance of Sri Radha Krishna. Freely perform any kind of spiritual sadhana, but it must be associated with the loving remembrance of Sri Radha Krishna with the mind. Bhakti karo kobi Govind Radhe Rup Dhyan manse pradam karvade. Thus, loving and faithful remembrance of God with the mind is true bhakti. Deeply ponder over it and make a decision. Make a firm resolution. Make a solemn promise that before doing kirtan, you will first bring the image of God in front of you, and only after that you will begin the kirtan. And only after that you will begin the kirtan. You see, in the world, when we call out to our son, call out to our father, call out to our friend, we say their name, but before we utter their name, we remember their form. We say, "Oh, can you call him? Oh, what's his name? Oh, yes, Ramesh." First you thought about his appearance, and after that you spoke his name. In the same way, when we call out to God, Radhe Govind, so before chanting Radhe, bring Radharani in front of you, and with Bring Radharani in front of you with your mind. Someone might argue, "Oh, but I haven't seen Radharani. How can I possibly bring her in front of me?" Do you see your father every day? Yes. Do you see your mother? Yes. Okay. Think about their form exactly the way it appears. Think of your mother's ears exactly the way they are. Think of her nose exactly like it is. You can't think of it. Even if you look at it thousands of times, what about meditating on God's form? God says, think of my form according to the desire of your mind. God is so extremely kind and gracious that he says, think of me in whatever form pleases your mind. Think of me as being fair complexioned, dark complexioned, short, tall, fat, thin, whatever you fancy. I will accept your meditation as real. You can remember me by any name. You can decorate me as you please. You can make me perform any leela of your choice. I will welcome everything as true as real. It doesn't matter what is described and revealed in the Bhagavatam, Gita and Ramayana. As the basis for the remembrance of God is not only limited or confined to the knowledge that has been elicited in these scriptures. Uncountable descensions of God are taking place every moment in the uncountable Brahmanas, and uncountable Leelas are taking place every moment. Who will depict all these? The Bhagavatam is only a small book that consists of 335 chapters, 12 cantos and 18,000 verses. How much can it describe? Everything depends on your own aspiration. God has given you tremendous freedom. You can think of God in any form that suits the liking of your mind. You can change it as often as you want. God will accept them all. However, it's absolutely critical to do Rup Dhyan while realizing the presence of the actual divine form of God in the form that you meditate upon. This is the second most important point to bear in mind. Feeling the actual presence of God, we must think that whatever form we are meditating on is God, is his gloriously divine form, imbued with qualities such as infinite beauty, bliss, righteousness, youthfulness, almightiness, splendor, omniscience, etc. Always very close to us. Shyam Sundar is standing before you. Now what? Now you have to begin work. So invite Shyam Sundar into your heart and start your office work. Every 10 to 15 minutes for just 1 second, realize that Shyam Sundar is sitting in your heart. You simply have to realize, not say anything. Alternatively, you can see Shyam Sundar on top of a table in a corner and continue doing your work every once in a little while. Glance over at Shyam Sundar. In other words, we should never feel that we are alone. Regardless of where we go and whatever situation we are in, feel that Shyam Sundar and Guru are with us. Strengthen this faith through repeated thinking with regular practice. Every moment you will remain intoxicated with the feeling that the Supreme Governor of uncountable Brahmanas, who is all-knowing, the controlled, the eternal witness, ever-loving, supreme and all-powerful God resides in my heart. Consequently, your heart will become purified with the grace of Guru. Your heart will become divine, and after that, your Guru will impart the nectar of the supreme divine bliss of God in your heart in the form of Swarupa Shakti. From that point on, for eternity, you will be blessed with the supreme wealth of God realization. Divine bliss and liberation from the bondage of three mayic qualities. Jagadguru Sri Kripalaji Maharaj. Translated by Divakari Didi Ji, Radha Madhav Dham, USA. My humble pranams to my Gurudev's divine lotus feet for giving us the knowledge above the precious treasure, Rudhyam meditation. If you all want to practice properly, please contact us at gloriesofradhakrishna@gmail.com. So whenever we have time, let's bring the form in our, the beautiful treasure of our life, the precious divine form of Sri Radha Krishna in our mind, and let's chant Radhe Shyam. Jai Jai Sri Radhe.